Alright, my dear. So today in this video tutorial, I'm going to share with you Hooke's law. And I'm sure, I don't know you are studying in 12th class or 11th class, or maybe you are studying engineering. Because all videos I have created only for engineering student. And in mechanical engineering as well as in civil engineering, people study about this Hooke's law, as well as in 11th class we have studied about Hooke's law. Alright, so maybe you are in 12th class. I don't know from which country even if you are watching this video, probably you in the below class you got this law. So doesn't matter, I'm going to share with you from base to little bit advanced level, that's why you will understand each and everything about this law. So this is a very, I must say, this is a simple law. Alright, this is really simple law. Even I'm going to share with you where exactly you will make mistake in this law while speaking or while writing definition of this law. This is the general mistake I must say what I'm just going to share with you. So basically this law has been provided in would you like to know year? Then you will be impressed to know this 1678. And probably you wanted to know who has been provided this law. The person name is Robert Hooke. And because his name is Robert Hooke, that's based on his name, surname, they have given the name of this law, Hooke's law. That's why Hooke's law is known as Hooke's law today, which law we are studying. Okay? So the definition, if we'll go for definition, then it states that within the elastic limit, stress is directly proportional to strain. Now what happened if you were studying in 12th class or below undergraduate course, then you just don't remember this line within the elastic line limit. You just remember stress is directly proportional to strain. There you made a mistake, because without this line you cannot say this for Hooke's law. Because Hooke's law valid till elastic limit, remember that. And without knowing the elastic, I mean without knowing that, if you are stating this law, that means you are wrong, you are not right. Okay, so basically let's talk about what is basically elastic limit. So for understanding Hooke's law proper way, what you do need to know elastic limit. And for understanding elastic limit, you need to know what is stress and what is strain. And of course, to understand stress and strain, you need to know properties of material. Can you imagine how things are interrelated to each other? If you are not having good concept, I mean not basic concept of these things, then you cannot understand what is it and how is it related to each other. So first of all, we need to understand properties of material. And in properties of material, we are having one property that is known as elasticity. So properties of material, and among the there are many properties, see. So in this video tutorial, I am only going to touch one property, that is elasticity. So basically what is elasticity? Okay, suppose that there is a metal rod, and we are just pulling this metal rod, and just, you know, because of force we can able to pull this rod, and just we are just, you know, we just leave it after pulling maybe 2 or 3 seconds. Then what will happen after few seconds, it will restore to its original position. Suppose that after pulling it would like this, and just whenever we are leaving, then it is restored to its original position. Okay, so this property is known as elasticity of the body. Now here one of the interesting question I must share with you, and probably there are only few can understand about it, about the question, and there are many competitive examination that question, same pretty question has been asked. So basically, what about that question? They ask which one is more elasticity, steel or rubber. Can you guess, my dear, which one is more elastic? I don't know you can guess or not, but let me share with you, my dear. Steel is more elastic than rubber. Steel is having more elasticity property than rubber. Simple question, right? So this is all about elasticity. Okay, now let's come to the elastic limit. For understanding elastic limit, you need to understand stress and strain diagram. You know what is the stress and strain diagram? Basically, stress is denoted by sigma and strain is denoted by small e. And if you are talking about stress and strain diagram, then this is like this only. Now, stress and strain diagram for different material is different, so the drawing must be different. But here we are talking about stress and strain diagram for MS. M for mild, one of the type of steel basically, and S for steel. So if you are talking about stress and strain diagram for mild steel, then this is very popular. Do you know why? Because from this diagram we can understand it properly. So basically, from here to here, from O to A is till O to A, Hooke's law valid. And then after, you know, then after we must say the Hooke's law is not valid because its property keep on changing with the diagram. As diagram is different, that's because of properties changing. I have already shared stress and strain diagram for different materials. Well, I will create another video, that's why you can understand much better way about it. Okay, but today what we are talking about, you know, from here to here. So suppose that we are taking any material and we wanted to make valid this Hooke's law, then the material, the stress and strain proportion would be 0 to A only for the validation of Hooke's law. If you're talking about MS, mild steel, then should be from here to here if we wanted to valid Hooke's law and use Hooke's law for finding anything. Alright, so this is about elastic limit. From O to A, Hooke's law is valid and it is elastic limit. Okay, now from here to here, little bit also till here, it is elastic, but little bit plastic deformation keep on going. That means if you go beyond this, then it cannot be restored to the original position as it is. It will be little bit different. There will be little bit difference. That's why I'm saying like this. Okay, I hope you are getting, and you are getting some inside information about Hooke's law, which probably you haven't studied till now. You haven't understand or haven't got information, such type of information, from any sources till now. I believe so, because I am providing something indeed and awesome information in this video. Okay, so let's go ahead. So now, what is stress and what is strain? Stress is, again, if we talk force by area, and its unit is Newton per meter square. That's right. If you are saying this, that's right. There is nothing wrong with it. But exactly what is stress, you need to know. Suppose that there is a body, and in this body we are putting load, okay, everywhere putting load. And you know, if we are putting load and body is stable, that means there is something, reaction force is going on, and that reaction force per unit that area is known as stress. And here the reaction force and the applied load, you know what kind of things is going on here? Newton's third law, action and reaction. Again, we are using another law, and that law we can relate here also. So the if you're talking about what is stress in numerical point of views, force by area, its unit is Newton per meter square or Pascal if we are talking about in SI unit. Now strain, what is basically strain? Strain means change in length by original length. Change in length by original length, that means delta L by L. So because it's, if we'll talk about in SI, meter, so this is a dimensionless term or quantity, you can say. Okay, so here what we are getting here, sigma is directly proportional to small e, because sigma is denoted by, sigma is the denotation for stress and small e is for strain. So sigma is equal to capital E into small e. Now another, the different term I have introduced here, that is capital E. So you need to know what is capital E. So capital E means Young's modulus of elasticity. It is, as I have already shared with you, it is denoted by capital E. And can you guess what would be the unit of this? Now see here, stress, the unit of stress is Newton per meter square Pascal, because this strain is having no unit. So therefore the unit of E, Young's modulus of elasticity, would be same Pascal or Newton per meter square in SI. So this is all about Hooke's law and what kind of questions you can get, I can share with you, because there are many stress, just like shear stress, simple stress. Same here, there are many type of strain, longitudinal strain, lateral strain, volumetric strain. So those are all things you need to understand if you wanted to go in depth about all factors we have used in Hooke's law. But if you are preparing for plus 2 examination, then all these things are not required, I think. So if you are studying, that's okay, you are getting very good knowledge about it, and you what information I have given in this video total, that's enough for you to solve any numerical problem, almost any numerical problem, or maybe some tricky question you can easily solve, because they can interlink things with this. So for plus 2 level, this thing is okay, sigma is directly proportional to E, but don't forget to use this one what I have shared with you. This is the mistake 90% students made while defining or while telling definition of Hooke's law. I don't want you to make this mistake, because if you are not using within the elastic limit, that means that is not Hooke's law. Okay, so this is all about Hooke's law. I hope you got some inside information about it. Okay, so thanks for watching. See you soon in my next video. Bye bye.